In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to fold a snowman pop-up card. Ta-da! Its name is Nobody the Snowman because it's just a head and no body. Get it? Nobody. Wait, it gets better. It also has arms. So it's Nobody the Pop-Up Snowman. What, you want a full body? Well, ta-da! It is the full body snowman. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to fold the pop-up full body snowman. And then I'm going to show you how to turn it into a pop-up card that opens directly as the full-body snowman. And special just for my members, I have a separate addendum tutorial where I reveal my secret method for making the three snowballs nice and round. And for membership, there's the link. This snowman pop-up card is a simplified, more streamlined version of this snowman pop-up card that I taught on my channel 8 years ago and published in my Origami Pop-Ups book. Alright, so for this pop-up snowman, I'm going to use a 10-inch square of Kami. Begin white side up and fold diagonally in half. As always, make very precise folds and crease sharply. Unfold and fold in half in this direction. If I'm going too fast, you can always pause the video or play it in slow-mo. Unfold and turn over, colored side up, blintz. Fold all the corners to the middle. Unfold, turn over, and fold in half. Rotate, and fold the front flap up so that the crease aligns with the top edge. And fold this corner to this point. And fold it back on the existing crease. And repeat. So fold the flap to here. And fold it back. Fold the corner to this point, like that. Unfold, and now fold this edge to the crease, but we actually want to go a little tiny bit past the crease, just a hair, like that. So it's like that. We're still folding on this point. And open, and squash. So this is the snowman's hand. And repeat. If you fold it exactly to the crease, you'll end up with wider fingers. But I like it like that. Now fold this flap to the middle. Make sure that these edges align. So it's like that, and repeat. So the two flaps touch in the middle. And unfold the flaps. And now fold this flap up so that the edge touches this point. like that. And this is the arm. You can taper it so it gets a little bit more narrow. Now, there's a little gap right here. If that's okay, no worries, but if you want to fix that, then just open it up and re-squash like that. And repeat. And if you want, you can make the fingers closer together by doing something like that. I just went from here to there. I'm going to do one hand like that and one hand like this. Now let's work on the bottom snowball. So we're going to make a pinch mark. So fold this edge to the crease, but we're not folding. We're just lining it up and just pinching right there. So we have this point. And repeat. Rotate. Fold on this crease. But we just want to pinch it so it sticks up like that. And now fold it so that this edge touches our two points. So it's like that. And unfold. And now fold on this crease, folding behind. Rotate and fold this corner to the crease. And repeat. Unfold, turn over, and refold on this side. So we're just reversing the creases. You might want to erase it by just pressing on it. And now go like that. And repeat. Now we're going to make a little pinch mark right on this edge, just like that. And repeat. Now take this flap and fold it behind. Like that. It was like this, and we just folded it on the pinch mark and extend that fold, making sure that it's parallel with this edge. And repeat. Okay, our octagon is almost complete. We just need to fold this. And for a guideline, what you can do is, well, don't fold it. Just bend it so that these edges align and these edges align. And once they align, now just bring this up like this. So there's no fold here. It's just bent and unfold. I mean, unbend. Turn over. And fold this up, letting the flap swing out. And we have the bottom snowball. Now we're going to make the middle snowball. So refold this and this. And fold this edge behind, trying to make it align with this edge. And you can just eyeball it. I mean, if you made a crease here, it'd be easier, but then you'd have an extra crease. And we're trying to avoid extra creases. because creases are ugly. I don't know why we're into origami. Just kidding. Okay. And unfold. That's pretty good. Yeah, so there's the arm and repeat on this side. Okay, so there's one octagon, two octagons, and now let's work on the head. So fold this flap down on this edge and really wrap it tightly around the edge so it's perfect. And now fold up so that these two points touch the top edge like this. And fold the triangle in like this and repeat. Turn over and now take this flap and fold this interior flap up to the crease. Like that. And repeat. So those two corners in an ideal world should touch. Well, it's not quite an ideal world, but close enough. Okay, now fold this flap up so that it goes between these two points. And again, we could make a crease to make this exact, but let's avoid making extra creases. And fold this edge up about like that. And fold this edge so that it touches this point like that. And repeat. And we have a nice heart. And turn over. And here is our robot snowman. Fold this flap up, letting the top swing down like that. Rotate. And fold this flap between this point and this point. And repeat. Make that nice and sharp. Now fold this flap up, letting the flap swing back into place. And there we have the snowman. And now I'm going to show you how to make it pop up. So we're going to close the card. We're just going to worry about the head for now. So fold it in half, letting the head swing down like that, and fold in half, making sure that you're folding right on the existing crease. Like that. So there's the head. And now for Nobody Snowman, you're just going to fold this up right on this edge, but through all layers, so the two octagons align with each other. And then this is going to go under here, but so we don't have these triangles, let's just fold it like this. Eliminate the white triangles. So there and there. Now on this one, if you just fold like this, you're not going to fully eliminate it. So open up the pocket and just squash it This is a little tricky, and be careful not to tear right here if you haven't already. That worked. Yeah, okay. And repeat. So open up the pocket and squash it. Like that. All right, so where were we? So fold this up and tuck this under here, and now fold in half like this, and we have, ta-da, the nobody snowman. And where is the somebody? Where is the body? There's the body. And that is the full body snowman. Ta-da! Ba-da! Now I'm gonna show you how to make it so that it pops up as the full body snowman. So what you're gonna do is bring it back like it was, and now fold between this point in the middle there and this point. And repeat. Now we're going to fold not on the existing crease, but we're going to make a new fold between this point and this point. And let the bottom swing out as you fold it up. So I'm going to unfold it so you can see where that fold was made. And here we go. Like that. And now we can close the card, and this swings up like this. And the head and the body cross paths like that. And now when you open it, the body comes down like that. And you might need to exercise it so that it works a little bit better, but this one works pretty good. And so what you can say is you can call this a branch. You can say, hey, I found a branch. What kind of branch? It's a white bark, a paper birch tree. Look that up on Google. It's a paper birch tree branch. What are we gonna do with it? Elsa? Do you want to build a snowman? Yes, here goes. Dun da da. And there's the snowman. And crease it nice and sharply. And it's also, on this side, it's a hat, and when you open it up, a heart pops out of the hat. So that's a lovely model. All right, so if you like it like that, you're done. But if you want, you can draw a face on it. All right, hope you guys enjoyed folding this, and have a happy holiday. Bye-bye. Whoosh, poof.